Hello, my name is Ardi, and we are going to solve problem 3.17 from Sadiku book. So the question is, using nodal analysis, find the current I0 in the circuit of figure 3.66. So this is the figure, and let's identify the essential nodes here. So maybe let's start by marking this bottommost node here as our ground, so the voltage here will be 0. And then this one here is 60 volt from the ground. So we know exactly the value of this node here, which is 60. Good. And now we name this node here as V1. And then we name this node here as V2. Good. Now what can we do from here is we do KCL at V1 and then we do KCL at V2. We will have two equations with two variables. Okay, let's start with KCL at V1. KCL said that the sum of the current that goes in is equal to the sum of the current that goes out. Okay, that's good. Now, let's assume the direction of the current first. So I just follow this one here. So this will be going up. And for this, I just assume it is going to the right. This is going down and this is going down. Good. And for V1, the only current that goes in is from this current here. And that current is 60 minus V1. 60 minus V1. Divided by the resistance between them, which is 4. Okay, that's good. And then all the other currents is going out. This current here is P1 minus V2 divided by 2, right? And then plus this current here, which is V1 minus 0 divided by 8. 1 minus 0 divided by 8. I think we can multiply both sides here by 8, because if we multiply both sides by 8, all the denominator will cancel. So we will have 4 and 8 will cancel into 2, so we will have 120 minus 2V1. Good. And then 2 and 8 will cancel into 4, so I will have 4V1 minus 4V2. And then 8 and 8 will cancel each other, so I will have plus V1. Good. Now I will have 7V1 and then minus 4V2. Okay, and all of that will equal to 120. Let's have that as equation number 1. Good. And now let's move on to this current here, I mean this node here, KCL at V2. KCL at V2. Again, KCL said that the sum of the current that goes in will equal to the sum of the current that goes out. All the currents is going in, so we will have this current here, which is 60 minus V2. Divided by 10. Okay, that's good. And then this current here, so I will have plus V1 minus V2 divided by 2. The resistance between them is 2 ohm. And then plus this current here from the current source, which is going in to V2, that will be 3I0. 3I0 and all of that will equal to 0. Okay, but maybe let's plug in what is I0 here. So I will have 60 minus V2 over 10, then plus V1 minus V2 divided by 2, then plus 3, then we will have 60 minus V1 divided by the resistance between them is 4. All of that will equal to 0, but here We can multiply this by 20. Good. Then we will have 10 and 20 will cancel into 2. So I will have 120 minus 2v2. And then plus 10v1 minus 10v2. Okay. 4 and 20 will cancel into 5. So I will have 5 multiplied by 3 is 15. 15 multiplied by 60, that will be 900, right? So I'll have plus 900. And then we will have minus 15v1. All of that will equal to 0. Good. Now, the constant here will be 1120, right? 1120. Or not? No. 900 plus 120 is 1020. 1020. And then we will have 10 minus 15. That will be minus 5v1. Okay, and then we will have minus 2 and minus 10. That will be minus 12v2. All of that will equal to 0, or we can simplify this. I will have 5v1 plus 12v2 is equal to 1020. Let's save that as equation number 2. Okay, that's good. Now, let's set up our equation solver, which is number 5, the first one here. So I will have 7 minus 4 and then 120. Good. And then for the second equation, I will have 5, 12, and then 1020. Okay, good. I will have V1 here is equal to 53.077. Okay. V1 is equal to 53.077 volt. Okay, and then what is V2? V2 is equal to 62.885. But we are asked about I0. I0, maybe let's use another color here. Is I0? I0 is 60 minus V1 divided by 4. Okay, so I will have 60 minus V1. That will be 53.077. And then divided by 4. Okay, now let's divide that. So I will have 60 minus 53.077 divided by 4. That will be 1.731, and the unit here will be ampere. Let's highlight that because that is the value that is asked by the question. So I0 is this value here. Okay, that's all. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.